Gospel is very simple. Jesus Christ didn't come to throw stones. He came to save lives. You know, the Apostle Paul, he wrote something very interesting in the book of Acts chapter 26. See, before he was the Apostle Paul, he was Saul. Does anyone know about this guy? His whole purpose in life when he was Saul was to destroy Christianity. He went around accusing Christians, undermining churches. He oversaw the stoning of Stephen, the first martyr. And he writes this in Acts chapter 26. He says, "My whole life I have believed in God. I've grown up in the temple. From the earliest days of my youth, I dedicated my life to serving God. But I didn't know who Jesus was. I didn't understand who he really was. And because of that, my whole world got messed up. I ended up living a life that was completely contrary to who God is." But then he goes on to say, but then he met him. As he traveled along that road to Damascus, he met Jesus, got knocked off his donkey, blind and mute. Quite an encounter, right? And that same man whose whole purpose in life was to bring condemnation and death went on to write this. We've heard it already read to us this morning, Romans chapter 8. He said, "I am convinced that neither life nor death, angel or demon, there is nothing upon this earth and there is nothing beneath it. There is nothing present. There is nothing that is to come. There is no height, there is no depth, and there is no created thing. There is nothing that can separate us from the love of God that is found in Jesus Christ." Come on, if you're excited about that this morning, why don't you lift some praise to God? God loves us. And you know, just like the Apostle Paul, we can grow up in church. We can spend our lives believing in God. But unless we truly have an encounter with Jesus Christ, then we are going to miss out on everything God has for us, the freedom, the forgiveness, and the salvation that God has always intended for us. And I'm excited this morning because I know that there are people here today, and this is going to be your moment where you are convinced that God really does love us, that Jesus is who he says that he is, and that through what he did on the cross, that truly there is nothing we did last week, last night, nothing that's been done to us that can ever separate us from the love of God that is found in Jesus Christ.